going back, and I've been thoughtful in the area of this mayor's race we have coming up in New Orleans. And one of the things that I'm kind of pleased about is that it seems that the four candidates who are considered the major candidates all take a long-term look at the public safety issue. We have to do better in terms of making New Orleans a place that creates peace and prosperity, rather than just the concept of throw people in jail and keep them there. Because in one way, that is part of the problem. Our past propensity for putting people in jail and throwing away the key behind sometimes very minor offenses, particularly if the second or third billing. Those laws have filled up the jails with people who, none of whom would maybe be people that would resort to violence. So I think we need to concentrate on violent crimes, crimes which actually are against another person, crimes that would decrease public safety, not petty theft and drug possession. I think those kinds of crimes could be dealt with in terms of community service, restitution, but ways that do not burden the public with the enormous amount of money it costs to keep and maintain a person in jail. It's less expensive to have run a job program like Job Corps than it is to keep a person in jail, almost twice as much to incarcerate than to provide really high level skilled education. So to the extent that we keep locking people up who sometimes may be more of a nuisance than a true danger to the public, to your and I's public safety, what we are doing is pouring, like being in a desert and needing water and just pouring it into the sand. It's kind of crazy. We need to use our resources to help improve the situation for people so that they don't become hopeless people. Our schools need a lot of work. You know, we have kids who really, really need help getting to the level where they want to do well in school. So we have a lot of work to do, and we just can't afford to continue to just pour our money into keeping people in jail, some of whom are fathers. And keeping them in jail is exacerbating the problem of kids not having somebody in fathers in their lives. I think we would be better served with trying to figure out ways to use this money to provide employment opportunities, training opportunities, and keep the people in jail who we know are a danger to you and I.